must be a light switch somewhere.
Oh, there it goes.
So we're at the Great Wolf Lodge. It's been raining today. This is in Grapevine, Texas. At the Wolf Lodge, they require that you wear these wristbands. And the wristbands function as a door key and as a payment system.
We are being trained to use a one world currency, one small step at a time. This wristband is not the one world currency. This wristband is not the mark of the beast. However, RFID wristbands are an incremental step closer to that end. What is the end? If anyone wants to buy or sell, they must have a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name.
There's an artificial owl here at the Great Wolf Lodge. It almost looks real sitting up there. I'm back home now, and I cut the wristband off of my wrist, and I thought it'd be interesting to take a look at how this wristband works. There's a piece of plastic film covering the electronics. I'm going to try to cut that off. So now the electronics slip out of the wristband. The coils that go around and around made out of aluminum, and it's an antenna. This RFID circuit is made by KSW Microtech.
KSW also supplied inlays for Moscow's metro as a way for riders to pay with RFID cards. The Moscow metro is the world's second most heavily used rapid transit system, with up to 9 million people traveling on it per day. These people pay with tickets or with the smart card, another name for an RFID payment card. People are getting very accustomed to using these RFID payment systems.
It looks like that little black square is the miniature circuit connected to the aluminum antenna. I admit that it was convenient to have these wristbands as a way to unlock the doors while we stayed at the lodge. We could go swimming without having to worry about losing our room key. Also, with my interest in electronics, having a degree in electrical engineering and an amateur radio license, I admit that this RFID technology is interesting. However, I think it's sad that our society is so wicked that it is even necessary to lock the doors. The lodge doors automatically locked when we closed the door. We had no choice if we wanted the doors locked or unlocked. And the lodge probably made the doors that way to keep unpaying customers out of the rooms. They might also be trying to prevent theft or other crimes. That's the sad part, that we people are so wicked that this is even an issue. I also think it's sad that we as people insist on using money for everything. Whatever happened to sharing, trading, and bartering? Whoever controls the money supply controls the world, and we people just go along with it. For the love of money is the root of all evil.
When you are told you must have some mark in your right hand or in your forehead to buy or sell, please remember that the Book of Revelation made this prediction over 1,900 years ago. I hope you will repent before this happens. How? Pray to God from any location and ask forgiveness for your sins. Ask Jesus to come into your heart, to save you, and to help you overcome sin. I did this and can confirm that Jesus does help, but he doesn't push himself on you. You must ask Jesus to help you and give him permission to assist you.
For it is the day of the Lord's vengeance, and the year of recompenses for the controversy of Zion. And the streams thereof shall be turned into pitch, and the dust thereof into brimstone, and the land thereof shall become burning with pitch. It shall not be quenched night nor day. The smoke thereof shall go up forever. From generation to generation it shall lie waste. None shall pass through it forever and ever. But the cormorant and the bittern shall possess it, the owl also, and the raven shall dwell in it. If any man worship the beast in his image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation.